Let's go. Let's go. Macam budak-budak pun BBNU punya bahasa ni. Okay, the next one, kita ada the last part of your chapter, that is unit binomial vector, curvature and torsion. So hari ni kita tengok unit binomial vector dulu, kita tengok curvature dulu, and then unit binomial and torsion kita tengok next Monday. Okay, so most probably next Monday will be your last class. So the next, for this presenter view from Karen. Okay, for this one, kita akan tengok, upon completion of this lesson, you should be able to compute the curvature of a curve, to compute the binomial vector of a curve, and compute a torsion of a curve. Okay. So, basically, saya akan terangkan apakah yang dimaksudkan dengan curvature. So, kita akan ada unit tangent vector. You akan ada either in two space or three space. Okay. Kalau in a curve, awak akan ada x, y, or I and J component only. But if the vector is in a space, you are going to have X, Y and Z. And the component of the vector will be I, J and K to represent the magnitude of the vector component. So the unit tangent vector at equally spaced on point C will be given as in the figure. And the curvature of unit tangent vector C at a given point will measure. This one dia akan ukur. It will measure how quickly the curve change at that point. So curvature, dia bukan speed, tapi dia tengok berapa curve tu berubah at that point. So kita dah tengok unit tangent vector dalam kelas semalam. So what is unit tangent vector? Unit tangent vector sebenarnya untuk tunjukkan the change of the direction slowly when the curve C bends a bit as shown in the first two points in the diagram. So maksudnya dekat sini, kalau tengok dekat diagram ni, bend a bit, dia akan tunduk dekat sini kan, sikit dekat dalam figure ni. So when the C twists more sharply, for example the third point in the diagram, so ini dia akan twist, the unit tangent vector akan change direction more quickly. So remember, we are dealing with vector value function, yang mana awak ada position vector sama dengan x t of I tambah y t of j tambah dengan z t of k. So dekat dalam ni, ini adalah x, y, z, ini adalah dia punya equation for the x t, y t dan juga z t. Dan kita deal dengan vector function, meaning that you are dealing with the magnitude of change. That is why kita tengok dia naik and then dia turun. So dekat sini ada perubahan dalam magnitude bagi vector terbabit. Okay. So for example, the third point in the diagram, third point in the diagram that is over here, dia punya unit tangent vector akan change directly more quickly. Sebab yang ini dia naik-naik, so dia punya direction dia tu ke atas. So bila dia dekat point ketiga ni, dia akan tukar ke sini, then akan menurun. So because of that, the magnitude and the direction of the vector function akan move quickly. So that is why we are interested with the curvature. Curvature tu kelengkungan. Okay. Berapa kelengkungan vector tu akan berubah dia punya magnitude dan juga direction. So in other words, kita boleh cakap curvature is the magnitude of the rate of change of the unit tangent vector with respect to the arc length. And it is denoted by this one, K, curly K, curly K of the curvature, where it will be equal to dt over ds, yang mana t ni adalah unit tangent vector. So dia punya this one represent dia punya Euclidean length, and this one represent dia punya first order derivative. Okay. So ini adalah proving macam mana kita boleh cakap curvature tu akan sama dengan Euclidean length of the unit tangent vector dibahagikan dengan Euclidean length of the position vector. Okay. Taking the first order derivative for the both of the unit tangent vector and also the unit, the position vector. Sebab asalnya kan awak ada vector R. Asalnya awak hanya ada equation bagi vector RT je. So kita tengok formula untuk dapatkan unit tangent vector. So unit tangent vector macam mana nak dapatkan unit tangent vector? Unit tangent vector kita dah tengok semalam, dia punya t of t akan sama dengan r prime t dibahagi dengan Euclidean length bagi r double prime t. Okay. So daripada sini boleh dapatkan dia punya curvature akan sama dengan curvature is not in vector. Curly k akan sama dengan Euclidean length bagi t prime t bahagi dengan Euclidean length bagi r prime t. So ini adalah dia punya formula bagi curvature. So daripada sini, yang ini dia proofkan daripada first order derivative dia akan gunakan chain rule untuk dapatkan derivative with respect to t and then with respect to s dia punya apa nama dia curvature punya this one. So dapatkan curvature and then dapatkan dia punya Euclidean length. Daripada sini awak akan dapat Euclidean length of the curvature and kita gunakan this principle of equation function multiply with the vector of f. That is why finally awak akan dapatkan yang ini adalah dia punya persamaan bagi curvature. Itu sebenarnya dia ada guna lemma korelari tapi sebab kalau nak tunjukkan dengan awak macam mana dia punya proving tu terlalu panjang. Lagipun kau punya budak-budak matematik. So you just have to know that to find the curvature we will make use of the formula of the Euclidean length for the unit tangent vector dibahagikan dengan first derivative of the unit normal vector. Okay. So yang ini formula ni yang awak kena tahu. Tapi exam online pun aku tak ada ke hal kan. So atau kita boleh juga guna curvature. Another formula for curvature will be given as this one. First order derivative having the punya cross multiplication. This is cross multiplication dengan second order derivative of position vector dibahagi dengan Euclidean length of the first order derivative of the position vector. So the arrange the vector function and then the respect find the derivative with respect to t, find the cross and then you finally you will get dia punya proving lah sebagai another alternative way to calculate the curvature. So this is just to prove for you the calculation for the curvature. So from here, yang ini dah ada guna lemma and corollary, find the first order derivative and taking the Euclidean length and everything. So kau tengok yang ini je lah as proven. So this is all other formula to get the curvature. Either you can use a unit tangent vector dibahagikan dengan Euclidean length of the position vector. Or you may also use this this one, okay? That is the another alternative formula to calculate the curvature of a vector value function, okay? So yang ini curvature in curve along the curve. That is if you have x of t and y of t, okay? You have x and y space I and j, but if you have for the one in plane curve, the sign of curvature indicates the direction of rotation of the tangent vector t as a function of the parameter along the curve. So if t rotates in counterclockwise, the direction of the unit normal vector n will point to the oscillating circle. So for this one, kalau dia adalah melawan arah jam, so awak akan dapat dia akan berputar secara berputar in oscillating circle. So where from here it will give the position of the curvature. Dia akan bagi dekat mana position bagi sesuatu curvature. So the red color yang ini adalah unit tangent vector dan yang blue one is the unit normal vector. Yang ini awak dah belajar dalam kelas semalam. So dekat ini adalah awak punya vector r of t. Okay. So daripada sini kita tengok dekat mana dia punya magnitude dia berubah. So if it rotate in clockwise, it will give a negative curvature. Okay. So if you get the curvature greater than zero, meaning that dia punya rotation is counter clockwise. And in this case, the rotation will be in clockwise rotation. Okay. So Okay, ada soalan tak so far? Get well soon. Wah. BKP ni dah ni. Tarok. Okay, okay. I'm still alive. And still have the high spirit to teach you about curvature. Okay, then class. So, sorry for the interruption. Just a bit of couch actually. Nothing serious. Dah tua macam tu lah. Nanti bila korang dah tua. Pasti lah. Okay. So, curvature of a plane of curve. So, the next one, kita ada the continuation for the curvature. So, curvature, actually, it measure on the non-linearity at the point of P. So, a curve with zero curvature is a line. So, kalau awak kira dapat dia punya curvature K equal to zero, actually, it represent a line. So, curvature at point W is zero. Sebab dekat sini, dia menunjukkan macam satu straight line. So, there is no curvature, there is no changing of direction at the point of W. So based on the rotation direction of the tangent vector or direction of normal vector, the curvature at point U is negative while the curvature at point V is positive. Sebab dekat point U tu dia akan counterclockwise dekat sini, curvature dia akan greater than zero, and for here dia akan less than zero, meaning that you are going to have the negative, the clockwise. In here, it will be clockwise at the point of U, and at the point of V, dia akan jadi counterclockwise. Okay. So, basically, this is all the explanation of the curvature. The radius of the curvature will be given by R equal to 1 per the value of the curvature. Okay. Sebab dekat area situ, yang bulatan tu adalah dia punya curvature. So, curvature at point U is higher than the one at the point V since the tangent vector bends more at point U compared to point V. And the radius of curvature at point U is smaller compared to point V as radius of the curvature is inversely proportional to the radius of the curvature. Okay. So, dia punya curvature tu lebih banyak, dia punya curve. Sebab dia berkaitan dengan direction kan, berapa perubahan direction tu. So dekat sini dia punya perubahan tu sharp, dia akan menurun. Kalau dekat sini dia punya curve tu tak tinggi, tak naik tinggi sangat. So macam kalau kau main apa nama dia tu, mendalah tu, skateboard kan. Kalau turun bukit tu, macam laju gitu. Curaman, kecuraman dia tu. Curvature, kecuraman dia tu tinggi. Okay. So kalau dekat point V tu awak tengok kecuraman dia landai sikit kan. Dia tak berapa tinggi. That is why the curvature is much more higher at the point of U. Okay. So nampak eh? Nanti by today lah saya bagi slide. Tengah type-type sikit. Okay, done. So, in a space curve, that is, if you have three dimension, for a moving particle with a unit speed along a space curve, the curvature will be the magnitude of its acceleration. So in this case, berapakah magnitude bagi dia punya acceleration? So difference from curvature in a plane curve, curvature of a space curve is always non-negative. That means it will having a positive value from zero up until infinity. Okay. So curvature of space curve will be discussed again after binormal vector is introduced in the next section. Okay, kita akan tengok this one untuk the next section. So sebab tadi kita deal with line X dan Y. So kalau dalam space yang awak ada X, Y, Z, the curvature will be line sikit. That one will be extension where we will discuss this Monday. So example, find the curvature RT of 3 cos T, 3 sin, 3 cos TI, 3 sin TJ plus TK by using the formula curvature akan sama dengan this one, Euclidean length of the unit tangent vector dibahagi dengan Euclidean length of the first order derivative of the position vector. So, cuba salin dulu soalan tu. Kita buat satu-satu. Example 1 and example 2. So, you copy the question first and then yang tadi banyak-banyak tu, I just give you an explanation so that you get the idea what the curvature mean. Okay. Well, most important is how you are going to find the curvature of a curve. Curvature of a vector value function. So, salin dulu example 1. So we will go through one by one, example 1 and example 2. So dia ada dua formula nak dapatkan curvature. Ini ada satu formula, another one you have this formula. So there is two formula in how you are going to get the curvature. Done. Dah salin soalan. Oi, dah. Senyap je dulu, done.
Dah.
Okay. So, kita tengok example one. So, example one, dia kata... you were given dia punya vector function RT akan sama dengan 3 cos TI, 3 sin TJ dan juga TK. So dia kata dapatkan curvature by using the formula of unit tangent vector punya Euclidean length bahagi dengan unit normal vector punya Euclidean length. So, daripada sini, kita ada formula unit tangent vector T of T akan sama dengan R prime T dibahagi dengan Euclidean length of R prime T. Okay. So, dapatkan first order derivative dan juga Euclidean length of vector R. Okay. So, awak punya R T sama dengan 3 cos TI tambah 3 sin TJ tambah dengan TK. So R prime T, okay, bezakan 3 cos akan dapat negatif 3 sin TI. Bezakan sin dapat tambah 3 cos TJ. Bezakan T dapat 1. So itu adalah awak punya R prime T. So dapatkan Euclidean length bagi R prime T. Okay. Euclidean length akan sama dengan set negatif 3 sin T kuasa 2 tambah 3 cos T kuasa 2 tambah 1 kuasa 2. This one. Set 9 sin squared T tambah 9 cos squared T tambah 1. So that means set 9 sin squared T tambah cos squared T tambah 1. Set 9 tambah 1, set 10. So dapat Euclidean length of R prime T akan sama dengan 10. Set 10, not 10. So, boleh dapat unit tangent vector. Hence, unit tangent vector akan sama dengan 1 per set 10 negatif 3 sin T, 3 cos T dan juga 1. So unit tangent vector. Then dapatkan T. Ini unit tangent vector. Silap. This is your T of T. Ini adalah unit tangent vector. T of T. Okay. Dia bukan first order derivative. This is unit tangent vector, T of T. Okay. So, masukkan dalam sini. So, bezakan first order partial derivative of the unit tangent vector. Bezakan 1 per 10, negatif 3 sin T. Tiga cos T, I, J dan juga satu. Okay. That mean awak kena bezakan this one. All of that. 1/10 remain dekat luar. Bezakan negatif 3 sin T dapat apa? Unit tangent vector sama dengan first order derivative of position vector RT bahagi dengan Euclidean length of the position vector. Dan kita nak dapatkan first order derivative bagi unit tangent vector. So dari sini dapatkan dia punya first order derivative for this one. Dan
Miss.
Okey, cuba dapatkan tu. Apa nama dia? First order derivative of the unit tangent vector. Awak bezakan 1/10 negatif 3 sin T. Yang ini kan sebenarnya. So dia punya unit tangent. Ni boleh padam kan? Saya padam sikit eh. So this one is actually unit tangent vector akan sama dengan negatif 3/10 sin T I tambah 3/10 cos T J tambah 1/10 K. Okay. So, dah bezakan unit tangent vector. Negatif 3/10 sin 10. Bezakan dapat negatif 3/10 cos T I. Okay. 3/10 cos TJ bezakan dapat negatif 3/10 sin TJ. Bezakan 1/10 jadi kosong. Okay. So means there is no K component over there. So ni dah tak ada. Okay. So daripada sini dapatkan dia punya unit binomial vector. Dia punya Euclidean length for this one. 1/10 tu perkali dia, kita letak dekat luar. So yang awak cari adalah negatif 3 cos T squared tambah negatif 3 sin squared T. Set for this one. Okay. Tambah kosong kuasa 2. So akan dapat sama dengan 3/10. Dapat eh? So daripada sini baru kita boleh dapatkan dia punya curvature. Rindu pula nak tulis kat whiteboard kat kelas. Masa bilik kuliah awak semua dah penuh sarang laba-laba pun. Dah lama gila tak ada siapa masuk. So curvature akan sama dengan Hence, the curvature akan sama dengan this one. Okay, Euclidean length of the unit tangent, the first order derivative for the unit tangent vector dibahagikan dengan r prime t punya Euclidean length. R prime t kita dapat set 10. So you akan dapat sama dengan 3 per set 10 dibahagikan dengan set 10. So dapat 3 per 10. So itu adalah dia punya curvature for the vector function of 3 cos ti tambah 3 sin tj plus tk. Apa dah pukul 1:30 laparnya. So kita buat lagi satu example, lepas tu kita semua boleh pergi makan nasi. Betul tu. Saya dah beli nasi kerabu ni. Dia setakat ni tak ada siapa berjaya cipta bau yang boleh melepasi internet. Kalau tak lagi best kan. Tengok-tengok orang masak-masak tu dapat bau. Kenapa aku lapor benar ini? Bolehlah nanti balik UTM. Contact saya belanja. No hal. Bila kau nak masuk UTM? Hopefully tahun depan boleh masuk. Boring hidup new norm ni. Nasi kerabu. Saya beli kat Durian Tunggal. RM6 je. RM69. Alamak, aku lupalah. Aku tadi ingat saya cakap dekat. Siapa nama tadi? Seorang je tu yang minta. Syahrul Aiza je. RM69. Tahun depan. Okey lah tahun depan. Kalau panjang umur. Kau sekali minta ayam serama. Ayam biasa-biasa sudah. Ha? Payah juga. Kau still ni record. Biar ni boleh. Nanti saya jemput. Majlis saja. Kau makan dan puas-puas. Okey. Adan. Briano. Dan okey. So kita tengok example kedua. Cuba buat example kedua tu. Dia suruh kira dia punya curvature. Okey. The example tu, you were given the vector R T. So example tu, dia kalau awak faham sebenarnya subjek ni senang je. Lagilah awak exam nanti online. So saya harap boleh score lah. Soalan memang tak susah sangat. Nanti saya bagi markah test. Saya letak dalam OBE system selalu. Terus put in there. Quiz memang semua rata-rata full mark. Tambah dengan 4 sin 2TJ. So dia suruh gunakan formula curvature akan sama dengan Euclidean length of R prime T darabkan having the cross multiplication with R double prime dibahagi dengan Euclidean length bagi R prime T kuasa 3. So tengok dekat formula ni, the first thing yang awak kena cari is this one. Okay. First dapatkan R prime, dapatkan R prime, double prime, then baru dapatkan dia punya Euclidean length. 3 buat cross multiplication, yang keempat baru dapatkan dia punya Euclidean length. So yang kelima baru dapatkan Euclidean length R prime tu dikuasakan dengan 3. Okay. So let's try this example step by step. So that is your RT. So dapatkan R prime T. Okay. So R prime T akan sama dengan bezakan 4 cos T akan dapat 2 darab 4 negatif 8 sin T I tambah dengan 8 cos T J. Okay. Cos 2 T. Silap. Cos 2T J. Okay. So tu R double R prime. Then dapatkan R double prime T negatif 8 darab 2 akan dapat negatif 16 cos 2ti tolak dengan 16 sin tj. Okay. So itu awak punya R prime dan R double prime. Then dapatkan dia punya cross multiplication. R prime kali R double prime. Sama dengan I dekat sini. Negatif 8 sin 2t. Negatif 16 cos 2t. And then your J component. 8 cos 2t. Negatif 16 sin 2t. So having the cross multiplication. So cuba kira dapat berapa dia punya cross multiplication. Negatif 16 kali 8 sin darab sin. Dapat tak? Berapa nilai cross multiplication? Okay, ada yang dah dapat? Berapa nilai cross multiplication? First order derivative and second order derivative? Negatif 8 sin 2t darabkan dengan negatif 16 sin 2t. Tolak negatif 16 cos 2t darab 8 cos 2t. So what will you have for that one? Mana pula datang 4t squared tu? Sin 2t tu dia remain. So 128 tu betul. Akhil. So dia akan jadi yes, jawapan Karen Mikael betul. 128. Okay. Yang ini jadi 128 sin squared 2t tolak 100 negatif 128 tolak dengan negatif 128 cos squared 2t. So 128 sin squared 2t tambah 128 cos squared 2t. So dapat 128 sin squared 2t tambah cos squared 2t. Sama dengan 128. This one will become 1. Okay. Darabkan sin dengan cos tu, dia akan remain the same. Sin squared 2t, cos squared 2t. So, the next one, dapatkan Euclidean length of R prime darabkan dengan R double prime. Sama dengan set 128 kuasa 2 taking dia punya square root. So awak dapat dia sama dengan 128. Okay. So itu adalah dia punya jawapan. Oh, dia hang sekejap. Internet connection. So dapatkan dia punya Euclidean length. Awak akan dapat 128 juga. Sebab kita ambil 128 kuasa 2. Okay, 128 kuasa 2. Aduhai, apa salah pula dia ni? So akan dapat 128. Okay. Then nak dapatkan dia punya pembahagi tu, awak darabkan, dapatkan R prime punya Euclidean length sama dengan negatif 8 sin 2t kuasa 2 tambah 8 cos 2t kuasa 2 sama dengan set bagi 8 tambah 8, 64 sin squared 2t tambah 64 cos squared 2t. So set 64 sin squared 2t tambah cos squared 2t. Okay. So this one will become 1. So you akan dapat set 64 that is equal to this one. Okay. Set 64. Eh. Screen lag. Alamak, sekejap eh. Okey, dapat tak? Sama dengan 8. 8 bukan 16. Okey. So dapat eh? Set 64 dapat sama dengan 8. Okey. So itu R double prime. Hence, okey, curvature. Curvature K akan sama dengan, by using this formula, masukkan dekat dalam, curvature akan sama dengan 128 per dengan 8 kuasa 3. Sebab dia ada kuasa 3 dekat bawah tu. Okay. So 8 kuasa 3. That's betul, 0.25. Jawapan Elfis. 0.25. So lagi senang guna formula ni sebenarnya daripada formula yang awak cari unit tangent vector. So itu, that's the reason why kita buat, apa saja tak keluar. Jawapan dia 0.25 eh. Internet connection problem kot. That's the reason why screen dia lag. Jawapan dia sama dengan 0.25. Ah tu 0.25. Keluar pun. So that is about curvature. So Monday nanti kita akan sambung unit binormal and also the torsion. So kalau awak tengok menggunakan formula, this formula is much more simple compared to menggunakan formula yang unit tangent vector. Pada saya lah, sebab awak just deal dengan satu vector function R, and then kita dapatkan Euclidean length for each one of that. So ada soalan tak so far? So far any question or so far so good? Setuju. Yap, betul. Saya pun setuju dengan Syazwanul. Formula ni much more simple daripada guna tangent vector. Okay. So far.